Our GDC episode of the bonus round continues, and this week we're chatting with the minds behind Portal 2, Chet, Eric, and Jay, the writers from Valve. What's it like to create a sequel to a cult classic like Portal? Plus, how do game writers create convincing characters and narratives? This incredible and hilarious panel tells all as we get the designer's perspective, and it starts right now. Hey guys, we're back here on the bonus round from GDC in San Francisco, and now I'm joined by some good friends of mine, the writing team behind Portal 2 at Valve. We've got Eric, Chet, and Jay. Guys, congratulations on all the awards for Portal, including Best Narrative. Now you're working on top secret things at Valve, but today we are going to talk about Portal.
Going to be one of your biannual attempts to get us fired?
No, it's, we'll see how it goes.
Okay, see if you can sneak your way
into that. We should just talk about Gabe's beard, I guess, right?
It looks
good. It is an awesome beard.
It actually does.
Did he consult you about beard growing?
He went right to the white. We talked about it. His kids wanted him to grow it.
Yeah, he's going to be a great Santa Claus at Valve.
He will be this Christmas.
But the question is, what will Valve bring to the fans for Christmas? We don't know, right?
So here's where it is.
The transition.
Okay.
Now, let's talk about, Portal 2, you guys gave a talk yesterday where you revealed the shocking news that there were no portals in Portal, right?
I know.
Never said that before.
Previously revealed in your little red behind the scenes.
That's right. But the thing is, fans love, obviously, what you did with Portal. And now, it's been a year since you've shipped Portal. Have you recovered?
Not quite.
Almost, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, this feels like...
It feels like it's like 2 years ago.
It does feel like a long time ago, but it also feels like this was sort of the final thing in the Portal 2 saga.
Although we are still have DLC coming out, right?
We still have the Puzzle Maker coming out relatively soon.
Right.
But just in terms of our... I don't know that there's... this may be the last interview we ever give about Portal 2.
You got the exclusive.
Yeah, this is it.
Thank you, Jay. But I mean, now that you got, you worked on obviously the DLCs, you got the new Puzzle Maker coming out. I mean, for you guys, when are you ready to kind of move on from Portal, Jay? Leaving it behind?
I feel like at least for a little bit, it would be nice to leave it behind. But there's, of course, you never know.
Well, the thing about you guys is, I don't know if people know. Obviously, you guys, like the Meet the Shorts for Team Fortress. I mean, you guys are involved in those, and there's lots of other stuff. Writing you do at Valve, even when you're working on Portal 2, there were other things to focus on, right?
Right. I mean, there was always the TF blog or comics or the Meet the Shorts or just random, there isn't, with no hierarchy, if they need a press release all of a sudden, Lombardi is like, you guys, write this press release. So there's always something to do.
We just wrapped up the last Meet the Short, Pyro.
Which isn't, not released yet, but is done.
It's long in production, though.
In the can,
right?
Yeah. So we'll be releasing that soon with something else as well.
Okay.
So Eric actually wrote a bunch of people's bios that never made it to the webpage.
So many good
bios. They were so good at bios. Yeah. So it's just people would throw some information out and get a bio we could never, ever publish anywhere.
We could publish
a lot of people
them.
Were war
why
heroes.
We didn't. That, they
some other things.
There was a lot of good bios.
Shocking bios.
They weren't even that shocking. They were just kind of funny. Yeah, I mean, funny. I just didn't... You probably don't want to hear my whole manifesto on bios, but...
No, you don't like bios?
No, I think, who cares where somebody went to college? Tell me something interesting, even if it's made up.
Yeah, that's what we found. In Final Hours, we found out about you guys back in the days of hackers and all that stuff, so that people want to find out the real story. Let's talk a bit about, Valve, obviously, you guys are legendary out there for the fans. They're always curious kind of what you guys are working on. What have you been doing since Portal 2 ship? You're working on the DLC, obviously, right? You've been working on the Meet the Short.
DLCs, Meet the Shorts, unannounced things.
Right.
Counter-Strike Global Offensive.
Oh yeah, Counter-Strike.
That's right. Chet has been working. You've been working on CS:GO. That's coming out, right?
Yeah, in beta now.
We've got Dota coming.
Right. You guys involved in Dota at all?
Not a whole lot. A little bit here and there.
You did a little.
A little, but mostly involved in playing it. Not so much the making.
Yeah, that's Mark Laidlaw and one of our new guys, Chris Katz. Guy actually was in support. Oh, that's right. Oh, my God. I forgot.
Is Chris writing?
You're the one who knows.
Broke him, actually.
I exposed the world.
He's actually working
I wasn't in that one, so I didn't
read it. That's a separate chapter. Oh, so Chris is a writer now.
Yeah, he is. Actually, this year, he's just blossomed into...
This guy's... it's like from
text support
to level design to writing. Watch out for Chris Katz.
Yeah. You're going to grow a beard and be Gabe.
That's all it takes, right? Yeah. So you guys, you know, I'm interested in sort of how you guys work at Valve, because you obviously have, you know, an intense development on something like Portal, and then in the year since, I mean, has it been more relaxing for you guys, or are you still kind of stressed out, you know, because writing is such a, you know, it's a creative process, but it's like, does it come in sort of spurts of like, hey, with this 3 months, we've got to focus on this, or how do you
guys
work?
I mean, it's more project oriented. I mean, we're not like sitting around waiting for inspiration to strike and then going crazy. You got to deliver stuff. It's definitely, I mean, speaking for myself, it's been a lot less stressful this year, say, than it was last year. You know, the DLC had a few weeks of kind of intense work. Right. Portal near the end was a long, sustained kind of march towards shipping a big product. So it's definitely less stressful this year.
Yeah. At the end, you always had, like, there's a couple of maps that just didn't have anything yet in them, and you're like, are we out of jokes for GLaDOS forever? And this is not going to ever come to us.
I mean, Jay and I literally be sitting in the room trying to think of people Jay knew from his college comedy paper that we could call up, because we needed like 5%. Yeah, just give us one joke. Yeah. We've got to fill in one more joke. We're out. We have no more jokes left.
Well, because sometimes when you wrap a big game like Portal, you know, a lot of other game companies just kind of roll right on to sequels. And it's like, do you feel in some ways like the Portal universe, do you feel kind of like done with it? Or do you, in the year since, you've been like, oh my God, we got all these great ideas?
I mean, we are always having ideas. And I feel like at least Aperture is something that you could go back to and keep exploring. You know, I think if we were ever to do more Portal, we probably couldn't bring Chell back again. We'd have to deal with that problem. Right. I mean, there'd be a whole bunch of problems to solve.
But open world Chell game.
No, you're actually redescribing our talk where we decided to actually put all that stuff back in.
Yeah, so we're going, we didn't learn anything. We're just taking everything out and then we're not smart.
Yeah.
Now, when you guys, you know, at Valve, how do you guys think about sort of like what projects you're going to work on? Because in the Portal Making of App, we talked about how sort of you guys will experiment with things and stuff like that. I mean, what is it like? Obviously, you can't talk about what you're working on, but it's like after something like Portal, how do you guys think about things? You just sort of say like, hey, what are we interested in? Let's, you know, sometimes you prototype a bunch of different ideas. Have you guys done one of those science fairs like you did after the first Portal?
We're probably going to have one coming up.
Oh, cool.
Because there's a lot of people working on Dota, right? Dota's a big content creation push. And then, you know, the CSGO stuff was already going on.
I mean, there's always a lot of stuff happening at Valve, and we all have desks on wheels. So you move on to your next project, you're kind of just looking for the most exciting room, and then kind of wheeling yourself in there and seeing what you can add to it.
Build consensus and interest.
Yeah, I mean, between, if there's people not working on projects, they tend to be working on some, you know, with a small team on something interesting. And then it just, if it becomes interesting to a larger group of people, then, you know, it kind of gains momentum and then maybe it becomes a shipping product.
Right. So sometimes are those ideas that nobody likes?
Yeah, I mean, I assume there's little groups working on stuff because we're big enough now that I never even hear about.
the area where ideas go to die, I guess, right?
Yeah. Yeah, they don't always work. Sure.
Well, and that's even with Portal. We talked about how, you know, in the story of Portal 2, that you guys really had a bunch of different ideas that you experimented with. And that's one thing I think that, you know, a lot of developers wonder about how you go through that process, because a lot of companies, you know, are on a very regimented schedule about when you're going to ship games. That's one thing I think people always wonder about Valve. It's like, why aren't they talking about this game or that game? It's like, you guys, obviously, you don't want to talk about things until you feel like they're something you really know what it's going to be, right?
Yeah. I mean, because that's always the problem during development. We go back and there'll be people that, you know, as we were developing Left 4 Dead, we did that in the open. Yep. So everyone saw all the steps. And there's people who are like, oh no, it was this version at this event was the best version. Oh my God, why did you break it after that? And it's just like, so it's really hard when you do it publicly, where kind of letting things coalesce and kind of pull together. Sometimes, you know, let's just be a little bit more deliberate about what they see.
All right, we'll be back next week with more with the guys from Valve.